Digimon Master. Today I'm gonna talk about cloning. So the things that make your Digimon stronger. And as you can see, the clones, so we have D, and you can see here B, sorry, D, C, A, B, and S. For more information about the cloning, you have to check your Digimon by clicking X, and you can see, for example, here on attack, I have hit clone level 9, and I want to clone it a little bit more. So, I recommend to use two things, actually. I recommend to use the backup disks. Those are really useful on cloning, because if the clone failed, your Digimon attack can erase in the next cloning, but not much as not if it's failed. So for example, if it's gonna raise between 12 and 13, it's gonna raise, if it's failed, the next cloning stage gonna raise just until 12. It's not gonna raise more than that. And the next stage, and that's how it's going. So if it's your first Digimon, you can use a clone D. Well, using a clone D, as I can say, if you want to clone your Digimon, the clone D, it has around 99% success. So I recommend not to using the backup discs. I recommend to use the backup sticks, the backup discs on clone level C, B, A, and S. And the S is so hard to get cloned success because the clone S, you're gonna get like around 2% success and 98% fail. So we're gonna go and clone. And by the way, there's something in here. But the Jogress is, if you are, for example, willing to have one Jogress, you want to focus on one Jogress Digimon, you can clone him to the max, like till 15 or 16, that's gonna be the max. And the other Jogress Digimon, you can just clone him normal clone, like 10, 12, something like that, because he's not that more important like that. He's gonna give you better attacks actually when you're going in Jogress, but because the cloning gonna cost you way too much and it's really kind of hard to get, so I recommend just clone one Digimon. Or if you have just one Digimon that is not even cloning, like normal Digimon with burst mode like Vmon in here, as you can see, I cloned him almost to the max level, like 55, because he's a normal Digimon. So you can clone him all the way up if you want to use him always and make him your main Digimon. And I recommend to use main Digimon with a burst mod, and as well as you progress in the game, then you can use a Jogress, because the Jogress is gonna need the Jogress chip, and that I'm gonna talk about later. But today I'm going to talk about cloning the normal Digimon, cloning Jogress, sorry. So we come to this guy and go inside data center. So as you can see here, the start, you can click the start, and you can see here the level of the clones. So if you clicked in here, as you can see, the success ability is 106 and 115. If I failed, I'm gonna get just 106. I'm not going to have 115. So if I failed, I'm going to have a little bit less than what I want. And reset, just to reset the level, like if it's not maxed. For example, the evade here is not perfect. As you can see, there's comma. It must be 73. It must be normal number without commas, without anything, like 40, 50, 60. Without, not like 40.5 or 40.90. It's not perfect, as you can see. This is, you can do it in the perfect, in the first stage, like you can see here, the block is perfect. It's perfect. And as you can see, you can get them from data log in. Those are the reset capsule, as you can see. You can use them, and then you can declone your Digimon and reclone it, and that's how you do. But pay attention, be careful, because when you are doing that, you're gonna have to spend more Teras or more stuff on that. So if you want to get it really perfect, you just have to get like this numbers in evade and critical, not like this numbers. I really didn't care about that too much because I'm focusing on Ryudomon, but on Drumon. But I really wanted to make this as well a little bit stronger, so in order to make my Alphamon or you can a little bit stronger. So we're gonna go on attack, and you can see if you are confused and you don't know which one to use, just click this Digiclone. As you can see, it's gonna come there automatic. And if you have a backup disk, I recommend to use a backup disk. So you can click on backup disk, and as you can see, it's gonna cost me like 50 mega, and then you're gonna go to enhance. As you can see here, you can wait if it's gonna pick up randomly, or you can just click. And you can see it's failed, and I'm not gonna lose anything on progress because my Digimon, because I use the backup disks in here. The backup disks, you can get it from events, you can get it from buyers, seller, you can get it from shops, you can get it like it's not really hard to get, but it's really kind of, as you can see, we keep on failing, and as long as we are failing, the Terra that we have is going on, and the backup disks is just go away. And here we go, we succeed in here, we advanced to next level. Now we have level 10, and this one is gonna work until level 12. So we can reuse it again. I'm gonna see our luck again on attack, and we failed. As you can see here, the chances are going lower and lower as more as you progress. So you have to make sure that you got luck, and I got lucky, and I just clicked it randomly. Or you can just wait, and it's gonna take it by itself. It's gonna pick up randomly as well, but it's just kind of luck issue. It's just like you are trying your luck in here, and willing to have something good and not something good. So that's how the cloning works, and I prefer to clone attack on HP. Actually, I don't have a really good idea about that because I really didn't do anything about that, and it's brand new thing, the HP cloning. For me, it's brand new because I was really away from when this new thing just came out. I was really away from the game. I wasn't there. As you can see, now I have just 600 megabytes. I'm gonna try, and I'm keep failing and failing. So I really want to get one at least. Come on, why don't I have luck in here? You just got one luck, and come on, let me pick randomly. Okay, let's see. Oh man, I failed. It's failed. It just keep on failing. Like likely I have too many Diddy clones, so I don't care about that. But the Terras, I wasted almost a Terra. Yeah. I just have now 400 mega, and I have to farm Teras again. I have to sell the stuff again. Okay, so come on, last time. Come on. No, it didn't work. Okay, so it won't work anymore. So, I'm gonna quit that, and that was the tutorial today. But yeah, I just wasted one Tera. Oh man. However, we're just gonna see. Just look at here. You can see here the clone has increased to level 11. And that's mean on Jogress as well, it's gonna increase the attack as well, because in the Jogress, the two Digimons come one Digimon, and the boss attacks, the boss cloning gonna come like one. But it's depending on the Digimon that you are using actually. Like here, as you can see, it's just 7,532, but on Durumon, as you can see, the attack is higher, it's level 13, is almost perfect. You just have two stages, I mean the S1, and it's gonna be perfect later. So like if I just clone it, as you can see, here we go 8,352. As you can see, this is the difference between the cloning in level 13 and the cloning in level 12. or level 11 or level 10 or whatever. Okay guys, so that was the next tutorial for the cloning and how the cloning is working and what do you need for cloning. And by the way, you can get clones from quests, and before they were available in Digiclone shop, but I think they, I'm not really sure if they have removed that or not, but yeah, they are still available. You can get it with Digicores. Digicores came from scanned DigiEggs. And that was for tutorial. And the higher level is the DigiEgg is, the higher level clones you're gonna get, the more Digicores that you're gonna get. So that was for our video today. I hope you enjoyed that.